Good morning, kiddos. Happy Friday, May 14th. It is No Place for Hate Day, and I want to give a big old shout out to Miss Jackson because she made me this cool shirt. I didn't have one of these because they were ordered before I got to Duluth Middle School, and now I have one and I'm so excited. So thank you, Miss Jackson. What a great day for us to love on one another and just talk about how we can be good, open, tolerant, kind, loving friends and citizens. So thanks again, Miss Jackson. I'm gonna wear it with pride. We have no adult birthdays today and only a couple of kiddo birthdays. So happy birthday to Sophia Nguyen and Miguel Uzcategui Ferrer. Sophia and Miguel, happy birthday to you. I hope that you get to pick whatever you want for dinner and that you don't have to make it. It's Friday, so at my house, it's pizza night. I'm so excited. Hope you guys have the best birthday. Guys, we have no additional shout outs today, so just a couple of quick announcements. Tomorrow is our last Saturday school of the year. I need my 150 kids. I have been persistent in asking, but I have not gotten my wish yet. So I really hope tomorrow is the day that I get my 150 kiddos. There is no reason not to come here. It's free. There's no invitation needed. We have plenty of helpers in different languages who can help you get those last few NTIs done. Maybe do that last reteach, retest module if it's still available. Maybe get ready for finals. Whatever it is that you need, why not spend 3 hours with us helping you get to your goal? That is what persistence looks like, coming for help even at the very end. All right, you guys, I hope to see you at Saturday school, and congratulations to the 7th and 8th grade band students who put on a beautiful concert last night outdoors. Congratulations to the orchestra kiddos who finished all of their recordings of their concerts yesterday. And Monday after school, if you are interested in being on the color guard, that's the group that twirls the flags and throws the rifles with the marching band at Duluth High School during halftime shows at the football games. There's going to be a tryout here at school Monday from 4 to 5:30. I'd love to see a lot of you come and try out. Getting engaged in activities at middle school and high school makes a huge difference in your academic achievement, believe it or not. All right, you guys, let's read the last little tiny bit of chapter one of Kimchi and Calamari. It is Asian Pacific American Heritage Month, and I wanted to read a book that highlighted the life or story of maybe an Asian American character. And so Joseph, we're learning, is adopted. That's the last thing that we heard. He has to write a paper about his ancestors, and this is stressing him out because he's adopted, so he doesn't know a whole lot about his ancestors. So let's see where we left off. I'm adopted, Joseph says. As soon as I sat down at the lunch table, more bad fortune revealed itself from under the plastic wrap. Mom had mixed up my sandwich with Gina's. I was stuck with peanut butter and banana slices, a hideous combo surely created to make POWs talk. So like torture, kind of. Nash caught my disgusted look and stared down at my sandwich. Yuck, that looks nasty, poor you. So much for special treatment on my birthday, I said. He passed me some pretzels. Your lunch might stink, but at least your mom's making your favorite dinner, right? I nodded, thinking about Mom in the kitchen, slicing and salting eggplant and sprinkling cheese. She had taken a day off from the hair salon to shop and cook. I shoved the sandwich back in the bag and bit into a pretzel. You're right, Nash. I won't let old Perutka be the Grinch who steals my birthday. So come over tonight ready for one grandioso Calderaro feast. All right, so remember his birthday meal is fried calamari, eggplant parmesan, and chocolate cake with gobs of cannoli icing or frosting. And he just invited Nash to come over for that special birthday meal. Let's see what happens when Nash comes over. Hey guys, I forgot to do something very important today, which is we have our new employees and students of the month for this month. So let's go ahead and congratulate them. I'm sorry, I almost forgot that very big shout out. Our employees of the month, sixth grade teacher, Mark Palomino, seventh grade teacher, Jan Beckwith, eighth grade teacher, Christiani Hills, connections teacher, Dahlia Hetty, and our employee of the month is Ms. Harriet Staley, who does all of our technology assistance when it comes to the programs and the stuff inside your computer. So thank you, Ms. Staley, for all of that. And congratulations to the rest of you. We will celebrate you next week with our yummy breakfast on our fun cart. And here are the kiddos. This month, we have digital and in-person kids. So two kids per grade level. Our sixth grade digital student of the month is Cheyenne Mitchell. And our sixth grade in-person student of the month is Adriana Gomez Ochoa. Seventh grade digital, Jocelyn Cruz Torres. Seventh grade in-person, Ashley Ortiz. Eighth grade digital, Yusef Alves L. Eighth grade in-person, Sylvia Caballero. Congratulations to all of you. Your teachers said lovely, lovely things about you and they nominated you. And we can't wait to celebrate you next week when we come around with our cart with yummy breakfast and a gift. All right, guys, love you. Have a wonderful day. You can do this. You will do this. We'll support you every step of the way. Don't quit. Must persist. Bye.